In this lesson, let us study about the points and crossings, important technical terms. What are points and crossings? So the arrangements by which different routes, either parallel or diverging from the first track, are connected. So if there is a track, from that track, either a parallel track or a diverging track, so that it goes into a different route, to make this, there are some connections, right, without any obstruction. Okay, those are called as your points and crossings. So basically, to facilitate the diversion of trains from one track to another track is called what? It's called your points and crossings. So what are the main functions? Now, once you have known the definition, writing down the function is very easy, right? The first one is what? To facilitate your diversions without any obstruction. Facilitate diversion. So this is the main function of your points. Okay. When it comes to crossing, it is to provide the gap. Provide gaps between rails to be crossed. So why we have to do this? We have to do this. We have to provide this gap for the rails to cross each other, because the wheel flanges can pass through this without any obstruction. So this is the main function of your crossing. Okay. Now, why are we providing points and crossings, right? What is the provision? So the first one being, the train approaching the railway station has to reach the allotted platform, right? So to receive the train to allotted platform, also to dispatch the train to the required lane, right? Dispatch the train to required lane so that it reaches its destination station, and also for the trains to shunting and marshalling, right? So that they're sliding, so that they can reach the washing lanes, slidings or loco sheds. These are the things which points and crossings will provide us. Okay. Now let us get into the technical terms which are involved in points and crossings. So there are many technical terms, around 27 terms. So let us see one by one what each term has to tell us. Okay. So what's the first one? The first one is the main or through track. So this is your main track, which is going like this, right? It is basically the railway track from which the train is deviated. Track from which train is diverted or deviated is called as your main track. Right. Next is the branch track. So if you observe in this figure, this side track is nothing but your branch track. From the main track, this is from which, right? So this is the track on which your train is diverted. Okay. So the next one is the stock rail. So stock rail is nothing but your fixed rail in a railway track. RT I will call as railway track from now on. Okay. Against which the tongue rail fits is known as your stock rail. If you observe in this figure, you can understand from A to B till here, this is your stock rail. Okay. Now there is a switch here. So in between the toe of the switch and the heel of the switch, there will be a tongue rail. So this is your tongue rail. From here to here is your tongue rail. Okay. So stock rail is a fixed rail, right? So what in this figure, you can see the stock rail as well as tongue rail. So fixed rail in a railway track against which the tongue rail is fixed is called as your stock rail. Moving on to the tongue rail. So this, if you observe here, this is a tongue rail. Right, it will normally be tapered and it will be able to move also. It will be tapered and move. So what is it? Tapered rails which move and fit against their respective stock, because stock are fixed rails, right? So respective stock are called as your tongue rails. The other name for tongue rails are also what? Switch rails. So they are basically used to switch from one point to another point. Okay. Next definition is what? The toe of switch. So the tapered end of the tongue rail is nothing but the toe of the switch. Okay. So here this end this end is nothing but your toe of switch. What is it? Tapered end of tongue rail is your toe of switch. Next one is the stretcher bar. So stretcher bar is nothing but the bar by means of which two tapered ends of tongue rails are connected so that each tongue rails move through the same distance while changing the point. Okay, so what we have to do, this tongue rail and this tongue rail will be connected so that they both move through a same distance, allowing the movement of the train. Okay, so that is nothing but your stretcher bar. So here if you can observe, here there is a stretcher bar in this particular diagram between two tapering ends of the tongue rail. Sometimes one or more stretch bars also will be provided between your tapering ends of the tongue rails. So stretcher bars are also called as connecting rods. Okay, so these all things can be seen in this main diagram also. So if you observe, there is a stretcher bar here, right? So the next one is what? The heel of the switch. So what is heel of the switch? The untapered end of the switch rail is fixed to a lead rail. That is called as the heel of switch. Okay, so untapered end of a switch rail which is fixed to the lead rail is known as what? Heel of switch, or also called as heel of tongue rail. Okay, next, where you can see this heel of the switch, see here, you observe, this is the heel of the switch where the untapered end of your switch bar is connected. Okay, next, throw of a switch. The distance through which the toe of tongue rail moves sideways when it is operated is known as your throw of switch. So here if you observe, so this much distance your toe can move when it is operated. Okay, so distance through which the toe of the tongue rail moves sideways when operated is called as your throw of switch. So in India, the minimum throw for broad gauge is 9.5 centimeters, and for meter gauge and narrow gauge it is 8.9 centimeters. However, generally a throw of 11.4 centimeters is provided in almost all the rails. Okay, next one is the heel divergence. Divergence is nothing but the distance between the running face of the stock rail and the tongue rail. So the running face of the stock rail and the tongue rail, the distance between this is called as what? Your heel divergence. So in India, again, for broad gauge, this heel divergence varies from 13.3 to 13.7 centimeters. For meter gauge, it is 11.7 to 12.1 centimeters, and for narrow gauge it is kept somewhere around 9.8 centimeters. So this normally depend upon the crossing angle and the type of rail section. Okay, so depends on what? Crossing angle and rail sections. So this is all about your heel of switch, throw of switch and heel divergence. Moving on to the next, it is the heel block. So the cast iron block on which the tongue rail and the lead rail are bolted to their respective stock rail is nothing but your heel block. This heel block is also called as your distance block. So cast iron block on which the tongue and lead rails are bolted to their respective stock rail is called as what? Your heel block. Sometimes this is also called as distance block. So where exactly is it? See, you observe here, this is your heel or distance block, right? Next one is what? Your lead rail. So the name itself is indicating it is a lead rail. So the rail which leads the track from heel of the tongue rail to the toe of crossing. So rail which leads from the heel of the tongue rail to the toe of crossing is called as your lead rail. So if you observe, where is our lead rail? See here, this particular rail is our lead rail. Okay, next, wing rail. The bent up length of rail used in front of the nose of crossing, which helps in channelizing the train wheels in their proper route, is called as your wing rail. So the bent up portion, see here if you observe, this bent up portion is called as your wing rail. So this will help the train to properly go under the crossing. Okay, so the bent up length of rail used in front of nose of crossing, this will help in what? This will help in channelizing the train wheels in their proper routes. This is called as a wing rail. Next, moving ahead, point rail. So the rail of the main track forming the nose of crossing is called as your point rail. So here, this is your point rail. This is forming the nose of your crossing, right? Rail of main railway track forming the nose of crossing is called as what? Your point rail. Then is your splice rail. So here you can see, this is your splice rail. So this is what? Rail of the branch railway track. Again, this is again forming what? The nose of crossing. So if it is a part of the main rail, then it is called as point rail, and if it is a part of the branch rail, then it is called as your splice rail. Okay, next, nose of crossing. Nose of crossing is nothing but what? The point where point and splice rail meet, right? This is nothing but your nose of crossing. So the nose of crossing, which is formed by joining the lane of running face of a point rail and the splice rail of the two point rails, is called as true or theoretical nose of crossing. Okay, and the nose crossing which is actually provided is known as the actual or blunt nose of crossing, right? So normally, theoretically, what we practice, it's called as theoretical nose of crossing, and actually what we provide, it's called as actual or blunt nose of crossing. So NC is what? Nose of crossing. This is theoretical, this is actual. Normally what we do is we provide 6 to 18 mm more. Okay, that's why theoretical and actual are different. Understood. Next, the next one is the throat of crossing. So the place where the converging wing rail are the nearest is called as the throat of crossing. So there are two rails, no? These are, this is here, you can observe. The place where they are at the minimum distance possible, that's called as your throat of crossing. So place where the converging wing rails are at the nearest is called as what? Your throat of crossing. Then the angle of crossing. What is the angle of crossing? The angle between the point rail and the splice rail is nothing but the angle of crossing. So point between point and splice rail is called as what? Angle of crossing. So normally denoted by alpha. You can see in this figure here. Right. Next one is the check rail. So here if you observe, here we have given the check rail. So the length of the rail that is provided on the opposite side of the crossing to check the tendency of wheel to climb over the crossing is called as your check rail. So how exactly your wheel can cross, to check that you will be providing a rail, that is called as your check rail. So here it is, this is your check rail. This black portion is nothing but your check rail. So what is it? Rail length which are provided on the opposite side of the crossing called as your check rails. Okay, next is your flange way clearance. So this is nothing but the distance between the adjacent faces of stock rail and check rail. So the distance between the stock rail and the check rail adjacent faces is nothing but your flange way clearance. So here you have it, right? So this is your check rail, this is your stock rail. So the distance between this is called as your flange way clearance. Next one is your flare. So here you can see the flare. So this is also the distance between the, so the distance between stock rail and the check rail, but here we are giving some bend, no? That bend portion is nothing but your flare. Okay, so gradual widening of the flange way, which is formed by bending or plying of the ends of check rail, is nothing but your flare. Okay, this is provided mainly for smooth crossing. Understood. Next one is your slide chairs. So these are nothing but the chairs which are provided to support your tongue rails. Support what? Tongue chairs are nothing but your fixtures, right? So for sliding of the wheel laterally, we use this slide chairs, or sometimes we use slide plates. Understood. Next one is your facing points. So if your train passes first over switches and then over crossing, it is called as what? Face points. So if it is the other way, then it is called as the trailing points. Okay, so if it is moving in this direction, see here you can see, this is what? Facing direction, and these points are called face points. Now if it is moving like this from the branch to the main line, then they are called as trailing direction, and those points which come are the trailing points. Okay, so trains passing over crossing first and then on to switches are called as trailing points. Then overall length of the turnout. So here if you see, this is your overall length of the turnout, right? So it is what? The horizontal distance between the end of stock rail or the main rail to the end of point rail of turnout. So this is called as the overall length of your turnout. Okay, next, toe of crossing. So the end point of your wing rail, end point of wing rail is called as what? The toe of crossing. Wing rail, this is your wing rail, right? So end point of the wing rail is called as your toe of crossing. Next is the heel of crossing. So the end point of splice rail is called as the heel of crossing. Okay, then the last one is your studs or stops. So the bent up plates fitted to the web of the stock rail by means of bolts, right? So as to prevent the lateral bending of the tongue rails. These are called as your studs or stops. Okay, so these are nothing but bolts which are used to do the connection or the bolting. Between what will you bolt? Stock rails to tongue rails. Okay, so these are all the different important technical terms which you need to understand, so to proceed with the chapter further. Okay, hope it is clear to you now. Thank you.